Srinivas Ramanujan was an Indian mathematician who lived during the British rule in India. He had almost no formal training in pure mathematics, but later he solved problems in the field of maths that seemed impossible to solve. Ramanujan was a Hindu deity and was born on 22nd December 1887 into a Tamil Brahmin family in Erode, Madras. His father, Kuppaswamy Srinivas Aigner, worked as a clerk in a sari shop. His mother, Kumala Tamal, was a housewife and sang at local temple. They lived in a small traditional home on Sarangpani Sanidhi Street in the town of Kumbakonam. The family home is now a museum. On 1 October 1892, Ramanujan was enrolled at a local school in Chennai. After his maternal grandfather lost his job as a court official, his mother moved back to Kumbakonam and he was enrolled in Kangyan Primary School. Ramanujan was sent to live in Madras with his maternal grandparents after his paternal grandfather had died. He did not like school in Madras and tried to avoid attending. From his mother, he learned about traditions and Puranas, to sing religious songs, to attend pujas at the temple, and to maintain eating habits, all part of Brahmin culture. Just before turning 10 in November 1897, he passed his primary examinations in English, Tamil, geography, and arithmetic with the best scores in the district. That year, Ramanujan entered Town Higher Secondary School, where he encountered formal mathematics for the first time. He was later sent a book written by S.L. Loney on advanced trigonometry. He mastered trigonometry by the age of 13 while discovering sophisticated theorems on his own. By 14, he received merit certificates and academic awards. When he was graduated from Town High Secondary School in 1904, Ramanujan was awarded the K. Raghunathan Rao Prize for Mathematics by the school's headmaster. In August 1905, Ramanujan ran away from home, heading towards Visakhapatnam, and stayed in Rajahmundry for about a month. He later returned to Madras and was enrolled at Pattayappa's College in Madras. There he passed in mathematics but performed poorly in other subjects. In 1910, after a meeting between the 23-year-old Ramanujan and the founder of Indian Mathematical Society, Ramanujan began to get recognition in Madras mathematical circles, leading to his inclusion as a researcher at the University of Madras. On 14 July 1909, Ramanujan married Janki. After the marriage, Ramanujan developed a hydrocele testis, which is a type of disease. In January 1910, a doctor volunteered to do the surgery at no cost. To make money, he tutored students at the Presidency College who were preparing for the FA exam. In late 1910, Ramanujan was sick again. He feared for his health and told his friend R. Radhakrishnan Iyer to hand his notebooks over to either Professor Singarvelu Mudaliar, who was the mathematics professor at Pattayappa's College, or to the British professor Edward D. Ross of the Madras Christian College. After Ramanujan recovered, he retrieved his notebooks from Iyer. In May 1913, upon securing a research position at Madras University, Ramanujan moved his family to Triplicane. Ramanujan showed his mathematics notebooks to Iyer, who was the founder of mathematics department. With his help, Ramanujan had his work published. One of the first problems he posed in the journal was to find the value of. He waited for a solution to be offered in 3 issues over 6 months, but failed to receive any. At the end, Ramanujan supplied the solution to the problem himself. On page 105 of his first notebook, he formulated an equation that could be used to solve the infinitely nested radical problem using the property of Bernoulli numbers. In early 1912, he got a temporary job in the Madras Accountant General's office with a monthly salary of 20 rupees. He lasted only a few months there. Later, after 3 weeks, Ramanujan learned that he had been accepted as a class 3 accounting clerk, making 30 rupees per month.
In the spring of 1913, Narayan Iyer, Ramachandra Rao and E.W. Middlemast tried to present Ramanujan's work to British mathematicians. With the help of friends, Ramanujan drafted letters to leading mathematicians at the Cambridge University. On January 16, 1913, Ramanujan wrote to G.H. Hardy. The 9 pages of mathematics that was sent by Ramanujan made Hardy initially view Ramanujan's manuscripts as a possible fraud. One of the theorems Hardy found amazing was at the bottom of page 3. The first result had already been determined by G. Bohr in 1859. The second was new to Hardy and were derived from a class of functions called hypergeometric series, which had first been researched by Euler and Gauss. Hardy found these results more intriguing than Gauss's work on integrals. After seeing Ramanujan's theorem on continued fraction on the last page of the manuscript, Hardy said the theorem that they had defeated me completely. I had never seen anything like that before, and that they must be true, because if they were not true, no one would have the imagination to invent them. On 8 February 1913, Hardy wrote Ramanujan a letter expressing interest in his work. Hardy enlisted a colleague lecturing in Madras. His name was E.H. Neville. He mentored and brought Ramanujan to England. Ramanujan sailed from India on March 17, 1914. He arrived in London on April 14, 1914. Neville took him to his house on Chesterton Road in Cambridge. Ramanujan immediately began his work with Littlewood and Hardy. After 6 weeks, Ramanujan moved out of Neville's house and took up residence on Weevil's Court, a 5-minute walk from Hardy's room. Hardy and Littlewood began to look at Ramanujan's notebook. Hardy had already received 120 theorems from Ramanujan in the first 2 letters, but there were many more results and theorems in his notebook. Hardy saw that some were wrong, others had already been discovered, and the rest were new breakthroughs. Ramanujan spent nearly 5 years in Cambridge. Ramanujan was awarded a Bachelor of Science degree by research in March 1916 for his work on highly composite numbers. On 6 December 1917, Ramanujan was elected to the London Mathematical Society. In 1918, he was the second Indian to be elected as a Fellow of the Royal Society. On 13 October 1918, he was the first Indian to be elected Fellow of Trinity College in Cambridge. Ramanujan was plagued by health problems throughout his life. His health worsened in England in 1919 and he returned to Kumbakonam, Madras Presidency, and in 1920 he died at an early age of 32. After his death, his brother compiled his remaining handwritten notes consisting of formulae on singular moduli, hypergeometric series and continued fractions.